Singapore, together with Luxembourg, are the only two global fund management hubs that are AAA rated. They join the league of seven other Northern European nations, together with Australia and Canada, to become 11 countries in the world that are AAA rated. These ratings have been provided by all the three international rating agencies. Incidentally, United States, United Kingdom, and France, etc., are no longer AAA rated since the fallout of the global financial crisis. For investors, this is a great source of comfort because of the strength of the balance sheet of these destinations, as well as the full fungibility of their currency. On top of this, both Singapore and Luxembourg are full members of Financial Action Task Force, or FATF. And given the KYC and the supervision regimes that today we are subject to, this again becomes a big source of comfort both for investors as well as for fund managers. Singapore, a city-state with 5.6 million inhabitants, is a great place to live, work and play, especially with the Institute of Higher Learnings, good quality medical facilities, as well as excellent physical connectivity by air from all around the world, makes Singapore fulfill its substance criteria very easily. This often becomes a key challenge for other fund management destinations like Cayman, Bermuda, Mauritius, and even Luxembourg, where there are just about 600,000 people. As for ease of doing business, Singapore has been consistently ranking among the top three for several years now, as we can see from the survey reports provided by globally reputed survey agencies. In terms of the cost of doing business, be it one-time setup cost, annual recurring cost, operational expenses, Singapore is far less expensive than Luxembourg. In terms of funds managed by these two destinations, 800 managers domiciled in Singapore manages about $2.5 trillion of assets, as compared to Luxembourg, which handles a tad below €5 trillion, leaving a lot of headroom for Singapore to catch up. The variable company that Singapore has now put in place enables it to actually bridge this gap between Singapore and Luxembourg in a big way. It enables Singapore to become one of the preferred destinations and provide significant tailwinds for managers who would like to either set up new fund businesses out there or even relocate their existing businesses to Singapore. What Singapore has tried to achieve by putting the variable capital company structure is to provide a complete new framework for the fund management industry. The VCC has been set up by a promulgation of an enactment in the parliament, and hence the VCC structure is controlled exclusively by the VCC Act and the Securities Futures Act, and not by the Age-Old Companies Act, which was traditionally set up for manufacturing and services industries. Under the variable capital company regime, the net assets of the company determines the capital of the company. So the capital is actually on a free float. That's a significant benefit for fund management industry because it enables managers then to distribute the proceeds, redeem capital, raise new capital, as well as carry on with all those fund related activities without going through the solvency procedures that are otherwise stipulated under the Companies Act. The VCC can address both traditional or conventional funds as well as alternate investment funds, open-ended structures as well as closed-ended structures. At the same time, the liability of the LPs, GPs, directors, shareholders in a VCC is completely ring-fenced and limited to the liability or the paid-up capital of the VCC. The VCC requires to be audited by a Singaporean auditor. However, the audit can be conducted both in line with US GAAP or in accordance with International Financial Reporting Standards or the IFRS. The VCC also needs to be managed by a manager who is domiciled in Singapore and is regulated and licensed by the Singapore Regulatory and Monetary Authority. In terms of the governance and the board requirements, the VCC requires one director who is domiciled and is a resident of Singapore, and it also requires another director who is either a director or a representative of the manager. The third director, if any, especially for the authorized funds, it could be an independent director. But the most game-changing part of VCC is its umbrella structure. By way of the umbrella structure, there can be several sub-funds that can be created below the umbrella. Each of these sub-funds may have a very different investment thesis, investment ideology. It can even address different segments of limited partners or investors, as well as invest in different classes of assets, underlying assets. At the same time, the regulatory framework is very mindful about protecting the character of the substructures. Hence, it does not allow commingling, where one fund or sub-fund can be subsidized or supported by another sub-fund. Hence, the possibility of being short-charged between the funds gets minimized or neutralized. On the other hand, the substructures as well as the umbrella structure together fold back into determining the overall compliance criteria as well as substance criteria that the fund has to fulfill. This gives a significant advantage in terms of the operational efficiency of the fund. And hence, the operating cost, both in terms of setting up cost as well as annual recurring costs, becomes much less and gets evened out as the fund grows in its size and character. On the taxation side, again, there are significant benefits that are available, both in terms of direct taxes as well as indirect taxes. In terms of indirect taxes, the funds can avail GST remission for the management fees that it pays to the manager, subject to certain conditions. In terms of the direct taxes, again, both the fund and the manager are eligible for tax breaks, as a result of which the fund literally becomes a pass-through agency or a tax-neutral structure in the hands of its investors. Just like how a LPGV limited liability fund structure may work elsewhere around the world. There are several ways the newly enacted VCC structure will help fund managers as well as the fund management business worldwide. Firstly, managers who are based in Singapore and managing a VCC can assign the management responsibility of their sub-funds to managers in another jurisdiction, provided these managers are domiciled and regulated by the regulators in those jurisdictions. As for managers who are managing funds based in Singapore, these funds can be moved into the VCC both by transferring their assets and liabilities as well as shareholders. But the most important benefit that VCC structure offers is actually re-domiciliation of foreign funds. Funds that are based in other jurisdictions. These funds and their managers can re-domicile into Singapore and take not only the benefits of the tax regime that is being offered as part of the VCC, but also take advantage of the low operating costs, take advantage of ease of doing business. Singapore as a AAA destination in terms of credit worthiness as well as the strength of the balance sheet, and a fully fungible currency without any restrictions whatsoever. It will also help Singapore to climb up in the global fund management space. Today, out of the $2.5 trillion US dollars of assets that are being managed in by Singaporean managers. About 2/3 of them are domiciled in jurisdictions which are outside Singapore. With the VCC, it is expected therefore that most of the managers will now move these funds into Singapore, as it provides not just a level playing field but even much more in terms of the other peripheral business benefits that are so very vital and critical for our fund management industry. The VCC regime that has been put in place by Singapore, in our opinion, is a game changer. It provides significant tailwind to the fund management industry worldwide, enabling us to expand our footprint globally, managing cross-border and cross-theme, multi-theme funds effectively, efficiently, out of a destination where we can prove our substance criteria, a great place to live, work and play, as well as we can take refuge in the AAA rating of the destination and its creditworthiness. Thank you.